ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
సో హలో స్టూడెంట్స్, లెట్ us కంటిన్యూ విత్ దిస్ డ్రై ఇండేసెంట్ ఫ్రూట్. సో ఇన్ దట్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద 3 కేటగిరీస్? వన్ ఇస్ కారియోప్సిస్, వి కంప్లీటెడ్. సెకండ్ వన్ ఇస్ నట్. థర్డ్ వన్ ఇస్ సిప్సెల్లా. Right, let us quickly revise about nut, because nut is very very important and I would like to give one question. So let us revise the nut part again. So here number of carpels may be 2, many carpels by 2 multicarpellary, all are single seeded, here all contains only one seed, so here unilocular. Syncarpus gynoecium means carpels are fused. Superior ovary, so these are the characteristics, but very very important character is what? Nut possesses hard stony endocarp. Nut possesses what? Hard stony endocarp. Then where do you find Anacardium occidentalis? What is that? Cashew nut, its common name. Now if you look at the cashew nut, this is how, this is what I have drawn, is nothing but cashew nut. What is the scientific name? Anacardium occidentalis. Right? So in this, upper part is false fruit, fleshy pedicel is there, this is edible, and down part is nut, and nut contains true fruit. Okay, so here pedicel is also edible, nut is also edible, even nut is also edible. Right? So why I just repeated again about nut? Because let us differentiate so I have discussed about this nut because let me give you let us differentiate two things. What are they? Let us differentiate apple and nut, I mean cashew nut. Let us take these two examples. Let us compare. Okay, so similarity is what? Similarity is what? Both are dry indehiscent, no doubt. But sorry ma. This is dry dehiscent. Apple is not the dry fruit. Apple is what? Apple is a fleshy fruit, whereas cashew nut is a dry fruit. So far we have discussed about apple. Earlier previous classes we discussed about cashew nut. Let us differentiate, because most of the times, even though we go so much of people will go with so much of preparation, but most of the times they'll confuse in this case. So let me give you clear differences. Apple is a flesh fruit, cashew nut is a dry fruit. Apple is which fleshy fruit here? Apple is an example for pome, whereas here in which dry fruit it is? This is dry indehiscent fruit, where the fruit wall will not break, and in that it is an example for nut. Right? Now coming to this, and here when you talk about endocarp, endocarp is cartilaginous. Endocarp is cartilaginous. Coming to this, endocarp is, I'm talking about endocarp, endocarp is hard stony. Where else you find hard stony endocarp? Where else you find hard stony endocarp? One more question. One more question. Where do you find hard stony endocarp? Drupe. Under fleshy fruit we have berry, pepo, pome, hesperidium, drupe. In fleshy fruit of drupe also contain hard stony endocarp. What are the examples? Mangifera and Coccus nucifera. Mangifera, mainly mangifera, mango. Suppose sometimes you will get the question that hard stony endocarp found in which fleshy fruit? So at that time you have to take droop. Droop, example, Mangifera. Another example is Coccus nucifera. So when you make comparisons of the concepts, you will become the best preparation you can make out of it, and you will perfect with the concept. Right. Now, and what is the similarity between both of them? Here, differences I am writing still. Thalamus is edible. What is edible? Thalamus is edible. In this case, what is edible? Fleshy pedicel and cotyledon. What is a cotyledon? True fruit. This is a cotyledon. This is cotyledon. What is a cotyledon? You know, monocotyledon, dicotyledon. Only one cotyledon will be there. What is, we will discuss in detail about the same structure once again in coming concepts. Fleshy pedicel is edible in false fruit. Cotyledon is edible. Both are edible. Guys, even this also you will get as a question sometimes. In apple, what is edible means thalamus is edible. In cashew nut, what is edible means fleshy pedicel is edible, and cotyledon is also edible. Very, very, very important. Then why we are comparing apple and nut here? Because in apple also we find false fruit. Let me write completely better. False fruit surrounds true fruit. Surrounds true fruit. That means false fruit is also present, true fruit is also present. Okay, false fruit surrounds true fruit. False fruit is also present, true fruit is also present. That means both are present. In this case also, false fruit is also present along with the true fruit is also present. Okay, this is similarity. That's why we are comparing both apple and nut. Why we are comparing apple and nut? One is the pome, which come under fleshy fruit. Other one is nut, that come under dry fruit. Here endocarp is cartilaginous, very, 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 very important. Here hard stony endocarp is present. Here thalamus is edible. Here fleshy pedicel and cotyledons are edible. Very, very, very important. Then false fruit, true fruit, both are present. Here false fruit, true fruit, both are present. This is similarity, because both contain false and true fruit. That's why we are comparing apple and nut. Guys, can you tell me one more difference? Even though apple contain both false fruit and true fruit, but what is edible and what is not edible? False fruit in this case is thalamus. False fruit is edible, but true fruit is not edible. This is also one of the difference. I hope it is visible. Okay, false fruit is edible in apple, but true fruit is not edible. Why? Draw like apple. Okay, so here you can see center, you can't see true seeds, and this is what is called true fruit. This is what is called true fruit. True fruit is not edible. Why? Because here the seeds contain cyanides. Seeds has some trace element of cyanide. You know that, right? Even when you, generally I am telling you, general casually, like whenever you watch some movies also, in some movies they will show that they will take seeds poison. They will take apple seeds, they use it as a poison, right? Because apple seeds are little slightly poison, they are slightly used as poison. Why? Because apple seeds has trace concentration of cyanide, right? Generally in some of the movies they will show that apple seeds, they will take as a poison, right? Because apple seed has some trace concentration of cyanide. So here in apple, so this is apple, so in apple, true fruit is not edible, seeds are not edible, but here thalamus is what you call true fruit, false fruit. So only false fruit is edible. Only false fruit is edible, true fruit is not edible. This is one of the difference, even though both are present, right? And you know, in case of nut, both are edible. So in this case, both are edible. True fruit is also edible, false fruit is also edible. That also makes difference between apple and nut. Okay, so anacardium, cashew, here cotyledon, true nut, this is edible, this is true fruit is also edible. Fleshy petzel is also edible, that comes under false fruit. Very, very important, guys, we have to remember. Now, what is the third one we have to study? Cypsella. What is the third one we have to study? Cypsella. Caryopsis we completed, nut we completed, and let us study about what is called Cypsella. So I am writing about Cypsella, the third one we are discussing. Now when you take the Cypsella here, so here Cypsella is bicarpellary, meaning it contains two carpels or maybe multicarpellary, and it is single seeded. As usual, we write unilocular, no doubt. Syncarpus gynoecium, meaning carpels are fused. Syncarpus gynoecium. And the very, very important point in this is nothing but, in case of Cypsella, we find inferior ovary. What do we find? Inferior ovary, very, very important. We find what is called inferior ovary. Rest all, caryopsis, nut, both are superior ovary, but Cypsella, which contains what? Inferior ovary, right? Now coming to examples, when we take the examples, now when we take that helianthus, it's commonly called sunflower. Now in this we find awn-like calyx. What do we find? Awn-like calyx. So this is found in case of helianthus. So that is called awn-like calyx. That means in this calyx, it plays an important role in parachute mechanism. Right? Parachute mechanism. And helps in dispersal of spores, dispersal of seeds. Better you can take dispersal of seeds. And how? By wind. Okay, come back to this Cypsella. There's one more example I'll tell you. Cypsella, the number of carpels are 2, so we call bicarpellary. Only one chamber, one locule, so unilocular, because all are single seeded. This you are not supposed to forget, very important. Syncarpus, carpels are fused, gynoecium. Rest other two has superior ovary, but try to remember in this you have inferior ovary. So here you have to take example helianthus. Guys, you know Asteraceae family, right? I told you earlier also to remember head inflorescence and all that. At that time I told you Asteraceae, like helianthus, tridax, all will come. Tridax also will take as an example now. Helianthus, sunflower. In this, what is present? A calyx, it's like a awn-like calyx. I'll show you what is that awn-like calyx. Generally, the calyx plays an important role in parachute mechanism. I'll show you in the diagram what is parachute mechanism. As it is like awn-like shape, I'll show you the shape. Awn-like shape, I'll show you. As because it's awn shape, it helps in parachute mechanism. What is parachute mechanism useful? How it is useful? Helps in dispersal of seeds by wind. And another example I'm giving you, so I'm just continuing the one more example, I'll write here. Coming to another example, that is tridax. So both helianthus and tridax, both will come under Asteraceae. Very, very important example. In this tridax, we find persistent apapus like calyx. So remember, very, very important. On like calyx means, take the example helianthus, a persistent meaning it occurs for throughout the life, have a longer lifespan. Papers like means it is like a paper. Same, it also helps in dispersal of seeds by wind. Here also, this is also called parachute mechanism. What's the meaning of this? Now if you look at, so these are like this. Okay, so this will be like this, lines will be there. So this is like very thin paper calyx. So this is what is persistent. This is like paper calyx, persistent paper calyx. It is spreads through all directions. Whenever this will get matured, the fruit will get matured, cypsella get matured here. Inside you find seeds. All seeds are, this is called calyx, upper part is called calyx. Calyx is like persistent and it contain lot many structures through which seeds are liberated. So helps in dispersal of seeds. It help in dispersal of seeds. So this is persistent, occurs for long time. Papers means like very light in weight, very light in weight like a paper, and it throws the seeds to all directions. This is called persistent papers like calyx. And the shape, some different shape, somewhat like elaborated shape, then it is called on like calyx, which is found in helianthus. The papers calyx helps in disposal of seeds, itself is called a parachute mechanism, and that helps in disposal of seeds. Okay, I hope everyone understood this, right? What is that? Next one, cypsella. Cypsella means number of carpels are 2, bicarpellary, one chamber, unilocular. Syncarpus means fused. Inferior ovary is very, very important to remember. Example, helianthus, sunflower, in which what type of calyx is present? On like calyx. Calyx shows parachute mechanism, helps in dispersal of seeds by wind. So this parachute mechanism also applicable for tridax. This, if it elaborates, extends like a bigger cup of fruit, then it is called on like calyx. When coming to tridax, persistent papers like calyx is there, and here they are very thin and paper like, very light in weight, helps in dispersal of seeds, right? And remember, helianthus and tridax, both of them belong to the family Asteraceae. Oh, right. Come back to the next one. What is the next one? Dry fruits are divided into 3 types. Dry dehiscent, dry indehiscent, cyzocarpic fruits. Right? What are the 3 categories? Dry dehiscent, dry indehiscent, cyzocarpic fruits. Now what is left for us to discuss? Now we have to discuss what are called cyzocarpic fruits. Then we will complete dry fruits. Let us take cyzocarpic fruits. See, category of what? Dry fruits. Right? Spelling I wrote, cyzoocarpic fruit, right? Okay, cyzoocarpic fruit when you take here, in this case, the fruit what you find in this case, the fruit is splitted into, or you can say here it's splitted into number of fruitlets or number of dry indehiscent fruits. Dehiscent fruits. Okay, that means here, yes, that means here when you take splitted into number of fruitlets or number of dry indehiscent fruit, meaning here the fruit, F means fruit, fruit splitted into number of fruitlets or number of dry indehiscent fruits. So what happens here, each carpel develop into fruit, each carpel meaning one carpel, one ovary, right? Each carpel develop into fruit, a fruitlet, and number of fruitlets and join and form itario. What's the meaning of this? Number of fruitlets are joined to form itario. From one carpel, you can see development of one fruitlet. What you can see here? From one carpel or one ovary, better you can take ovary or carpel, each carpel that develops into fruitlet, means small tiny fruitlet. If it is a bigger one, we call fruit. As it is a smaller fruit, this is called fruitlet. The number of fruitlets, meaning so many fruitlets, they join and form itario. Or you can also discuss this as each carpel develop into one fruitlet, and fruitlets combine and form clusters. These clusters are also called as itario. I hope you understood. Okay, a fruit is the one which has been splitted into number of fruitlets, and each fruit is a dry indehiscent. So you can write number of fruitlets, or you can write number of dry indehiscent fruits. So when you take in this, each carpel develop into fruitlet, number of fruitlets join and form what is called as itario, or develop into fruitlets, and these fruitlets combine and form the clusters, and these clusters are called itario. Either you can write this definition, or you can simply you can write this expression. Both are same, expression is different. Cluster, fruitlets, itario, or you can write carpel, fruitlets, itario. Either of this you can write, right? And each fruitlet is called mericarp. Each fruitlet itself is called mericarp. And take down the examples. Acacia and castor. What are the examples? Acacia and castor. I told you, no, fruitlet. Now this is a fruitlet, right? This itself, each fruitlet itself, they are called as what? Mericarp. Each fruitlet itself is called mericarp. Now look at this one. Suppose if you take, this is how it looks. So here it divide into number of rootlet, right? And each one is called as what? A fruitlet. And each bit, so here I write, each bit itself is called mericarp. So this is a mericarp, this is also a mericarp, right? And in between what you find? Now totally this all joined together, and this bunch is called as what? Bunch is called as itario. Bunch itself is called itario, or better you don't use the word terminology called itario. Let us take this as constriction, meaning chamber to divide, we have constriction. Now what you can take, this is nothing but, let us take example, acacia. Let us take example, acacia. Now in this acacia, so if you take each bit itself is called mericarp. And after each bit we have a constriction, some space is there like oppressed node, and that is called constriction. Each bit of rootlet itself is called as what? Mericarp. Such type of fruits all together they are called as what? Cyzocarpic fruits. That also come under what? Dry fruits. So I hope you understood this. Cyzocarpic fruits, I'll tell you, fruits split into number of rootlets or number of dry indehiscent fruits. Now each carpel develop into fruitlet and form the clusters called itario, or you can write carpel develop into fruitlets, each is called mericarp, joined to form itario. The important statement in this is nothing but each fruitlet is called mericarp, acacia and castor. So this is now each bit, this is mericarp and this is acacia. You can see what is called constriction, right? Now so when we take the true fruits are divided into how many types? They are divided into how many types? 3 types. What are the 3 types? First one is simple fruits, and second one is nothing but aggregate fruit, and third one is nothing but what? Simple fruits, aggregate fruits, we write multiple fruits, or we write composite fruit. Now when we take simple fruits we completed. What are that we completed? Simple fruits, fleshy fruits and dry fruits. Fleshy fruit and dry fruit, right? So under this berry, pepo, pome, hesperodium group, this we completed. Dry fruits are dry dehiscent, dry indehiscent. Yes or no? That we completed. Dry dehiscent what will come, dry indehiscent what will come, and cyzocarpic fruits, 3 types we discussed. Now let us complete with, so this is first simple fruits is completed. Now let us go to a second one, aggregate fruits. Okay, what is the second one? Let us discuss about what are called aggregate fruits. Now let us talk about aggregate fruits. Here we are in the discussion about this. This is by two multicarpellary. Guys, very 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 important. Previously we have a neat question on aggregate fruits. By two multicarpellary, and very very important. So for all we discussed are syncarpus, and some are apocarpus. This is also apocarpus gynoecium. Okay, by two multicarpellary apocarpus gynoecium, and that develop from a single flower. That develops from a single flower are called aggregate fruits. Are called what? Aggregate fruits. This is very, very, very important. Are given, right? Sometimes this itself is given as a question. So very, very important previous NEET question. Mostly we get question on aggregate fruits. Number of carpels may be two to many, right? Then we find apocarpus gynoecium and single flower. Now each one develops into, here also we find what are called fruitlets. You can see formation of fruitlets, and these fruitlets are also called as itario. But itario term mostly applicable for aggregate fruits only. Rather than cyzocarpic fruits, itario term was applicable mostly for aggregate fruits. So itario is very, very important to remember for aggregate fruits. In this also you find fruitlets, and each fruitlet itself is called itario, right? So here the best example for this, Annona squamosa. Squamosa, what is that commonly called? Custard apple. It's commonly called as custard apple. Annona squamosa, it's commonly called custard apple. What is edible in this custard apple? In Annona squamosa we say mesocarp and endocarp, both are edible. These are edible, guys. You know, right? In case of custard apple, when we open it, you find each fruitlet. In that seed is also there. Mesocarp and endocarp is edible. Mesocarp and including endocarp are edible. So what is that? Annona squamosa. What is the common name? Custard apple. Try to remember that is nothing but aggregate fruit. Now is the time for you to draw what is called custard apple. So all of you know custard apple. You know it. You can draw better than me. I know that. Okay. So in this you can see here. So they will be like this. Inside seed also will be there. So each one having the seed inside, right? So this is nothing but what you find, custard apple. Okay, so what is the scientific name for this? Annona squamosa. It's commonly called custard apple. Mesocarp and endocarp are edible. Let us discuss aggregate fruits. Number of carpels may be two to many. Apocarpus meaning carpels are fused here. And single flower is there. Fruitlets and itario term more applicable for aggregate fruits. And later it comes for cyzocarpic. Mostly itario means you have to think about aggregate only. Aggregate fruits. And Annona squamosa is an example. And here you find custard apple. So that is mesocarp, endocarp are edible. And you can draw what is called custard apple. And what is the next we have to just go ahead with? The third one called as what? Multiple or composite fruit. We'll go with the next class. The next one, multiple or composite fruit. With that, the fruit part will get completed.
ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యారంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.